All I remember is my mother going to the hospital time and time and time again. And while she would go, she would make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She would say, "Oh Allah, purify my sins and allow me to see my children grow." All she wanted was to see her children grow up. And then in the 1980s, 1981 to be exact, she developed a disease called myasthenia gravis, which is Latin for grave muscle disorder. She lost her ability to walk freely. She started feeling like her muscles were weak. She wasn't as mobile as other people. Then she developed another blood disorder. She had to go through 17 blood transfusions in 2 years. After my brother, my older brother Jamal, was born, whenever she sat with the doctor told her that she would never be able to have kids again. And wallahi, dear brothers and sisters, this woman who had just started practicing Islam just a few years, she laughed at the doctor and she said, "You're not God." And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed her to get pregnant a month later, and she was pregnant with me. And whenever she became pregnant with me, the doctors told her that you're not going to survive, and your baby's not going to survive, because all of the blood transfusions, at that time there was the AIDS scare. All of these diseases that probably came in with this blood, it's not going to happen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala proved them wrong once again. With her faith in Allah azza wa jal, that was no obstacle to her. She never doubted for a moment. She never said, "Why is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doing this to me?" In 1990, she had her first stroke, and it was discovered that it was because she had throat cancer. She came out of that stroke and she said, "Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through this stroke has purified me from the sins that I had before." Then a few years later, another stroke, 1993. And they discovered that the cancer was getting more severe. She had to go through chemotherapy. The doctor said the chance of her survival is 40% or less. And then I remember on one night, and this was August 30th of 2007, she walked into my room at 2 a.m. She sat me down and she said, "I just wanted to let you know I'm pleased with you. And that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes me away for some reason, I want you to continue and go ahead with your wedding," which was just in a few months. My nikah was right before that. And subhanAllah, she started to give me her wasiyah. I said, "Mom, what are you talking about? Can you stop? I don't want to hear all of this." She started to give me her wasiyah because she knew the next day I was going to a youth camp in the masjid and I wasn't going to be home for 3 days. Nothing was wrong with her. She was fine. And subhanAllah, Ramadan was right around the corner and my mother was a pro at Ramadan. My father-in-law, Sheikh Hussam Mubarak, Sheikh Abu al-Abid, Hafidhullah, he used to make a challenge. He used to say, "Let's have a competition. Let's see who can read the Quran the most times in Ramadan." And I remember that previous Ramadan, a woman who could barely read and probably didn't have the best tajweed in the world, who only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could understand, and she finished reading the Quran 14 times in Ramadan. It was her life. It was everything about her. And my father told me that subhanAllah, those 3 days of her life were the happiest days of her life. She was just smiling uncontrollably, laughing uncontrollably, saying Alhamdulillah uncontrollably, and nobody understood why. Until Monday morning, when I was on my way to pick her up, she had another stroke in the closet. And this time she wouldn't get back up. And subhanAllah, I remember that week being the most unreal week of my life. I remember at the janazah thinking to myself, how was it when the Prophet ﷺ was buried? How is it that someone that's so amazing in your eyes, and she died on Laylatul Jum'ah, the night of Friday, alhamdulillah, another blessing upon her, and her janazah was after Salatul Jum'ah. And I remembered, how was it that they buried the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I remember that, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, she didn't have a single enemy in the world. Wallahi ya akhwani wa akhawati, she did not know much. She didn't have much knowledge, but it was her character. It was her character. And if you're wondering how I could put myself through that, I remember when I was sitting there and I was watching her being buried, and I think anyone who lost their parent understands. And I remembered Fatima radiallahu anha asking Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, how did you put dirt on the face of my father sallallahu alaihi wasallam? How could you bring yourself to a point where you could put dirt on the face of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And Anas radiallahu anhu said, wallahi ankarna qulubuna. We denied our hearts, we pretend our hearts weren't there. We had to eliminate our hearts to be able to do that. And I think about her all the time. For 5 years now, I've waited for the moment where I could tell her life story. A woman who had a possibility of becoming a nun or just a secular person who would drink alcohol just like everybody else in her family. But instead she drew close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and she never complained, and she understood that whatever came to her was a means of elevation. And whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you and I is a means of elevation. It's a means of bringing us close to Him. And wallahi, there are legends that live amongst us, and there are role models and heroes in your house. Thank your parents. If they brought you up in Islam, you better thank them for bringing you up in Islam. And I always, subhanAllah, say that ma ana illa hasana min hasanatiha. Anything good that I've ever done is only from her hasanat, because I know that at the end of the day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not have allowed me to be here. Not everybody can convert to Islam and come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So dear brothers and sisters, look for those heroes in your home. Look for those people that you love. Look for the people that have that amazing character, that exalted character, that are always smiling, that have never harmed anyone, and try to emulate that. It's easy to emulate the other stuff. And remember your parents in your dua. Do not ever forget them. And remember the favor that they did for you if they brought you up in Islam.